Hello everyone, welcome again to another video. Last time we derived the Schrödinger equation, but we did not talk much about how to use it or what its significance or interpretation is. Now, this equation does bring a lot of questions that are intrinsic and they are part of quantum mechanics, so they have to be addressed right away. Now, we're going to be working a lot with this equation, so I'm going to leave the mathematical part out of it for now because we will come back to it and we will be doing a lot of work with it. So for now, we're just going to go over this more in a conceptual manner and just think about what it means and what its importance is. So the Schrödinger equation, what it is basically, is just a partial differential equation which lets you solve for the wave function. So, for example, if you have an electron orbiting a proton, which is basically just the hydrogen atom, you can put into this equation the potential for such a configuration, and then you can solve this equation, which is actually something that we will do later on, and you can find basically what the wave function is for an electron in a hydrogen atom, and then you can use that wave function to find basically everything that you want to know about that system, and we will do all of that later on. So that is what you do with this equation. However, there are some questions that arise, because as we stated, this wave function is there to represent this particle, and that can be somewhat troubling because a particle is localized by nature, whereas a wave is spread out in space. So how exactly can we expect to utilize a wave function to describe the state of a particle? Now, the answer to this question was given by something that is called the Born's statistical interpretation, which I will write down here, Born's statistical interpretation. And what this says is basically, I will also write it down, it says that the probability of finding the particle at position x is, between x and x plus dx is going to be given by the following amount. This is going to be given by the absolute value of this wave function squared. Okay, and we are going to see how exactly to compute this absolute value, because we are going to have to perform an inner product, but we will see all of that later. So what does this mean? This means that times dx. So this means that if you want to know what is the probability of finding the particle in some interval dx, you're going to have to take this quantity. So this does bring quite a few questions too, and we're going to just sketch a little graph to try to visualize what is going on. So our x-axis, or our horizontal axis, this will be the possible positions for our particle, and our vertical axis is going to be this probability of finding our particle in some region. So we can have many different shapes for our wave function. Let's say that we have the following wave function, something that goes like this. Okay, so let's call this point right here A, and this point right here, B. So what this interpretation tells us is that while we may not know exactly where the particle is, we know that if we measure its position, we have a pretty high likelihood of finding the particle somewhere in the vicinity of point A. And if we do this experiment, there's a pretty small probability of finding in the vicinity of point B. That is what this Born statistical interpretation is going to be telling us. Now, this does raise quite a few questions because this eliminates the certainty that we are that we know from classical mechanics. Because now in quantum mechanics, this interpretation tells us that there is just a natural uncertainty. Suddenly, we just cannot know precisely where our particle is. When we want to perform an experiment, the theory can only tell us what is the probability of finding the particle in a certain state or in a certain position. So this can be quite troubling, and the question is this just because our universe is somewhat random at its core, or is it that our theory is maybe flawed in some way? Is it some mistake, or maybe is it incomplete? Is there something missing from our theory, or is it just that our measuring apparatus is not working properly or in some way faulty? Now, this is something that has troubled physicists and philosophers, especially when this when quantum mechanics was first developed. And I hope that if you are watching this, that you can also feel somewhat intrigued by this, because when we go into quantum mechanics, things just change. They do not work like we are used to in our classical world. So I really hope that I managed to make you feel how weird this all is. And in the next video, we are going to try to answer some of the questions that I raised here. And we're going to just see what is the consensus that physicists are agreeing on nowadays. So I will see you on the next video.